Complex problems, such as preventing chronic disease, are challenging to study and understand. As researchers, we are very good at being systematic in our work, finding, measuring, describing, and evaluating. But another helpful way of working is also increasingly used, the systemic approach that draws on systems thinking. This includes taking a view of the whole and seeing the larger context of how patterns emerge over time. The two words sound similar, but offer us different perspectives on complex problems. Here at the Prevention Centre, we've been incorporating both approaches for many years. This is what we've observed. Research, which may seem highly systematic, will often form part of a project with systemic elements, like embedding researchers with policymakers to support implementation. Vice versa, research using systemic methods also benefits from systematic protocols. Both approaches are useful tools, and when used together, they make a powerful combination. It's important to strike a balance when using them both. It's not a 50-50 rule. There's no one-size-fits-all. It depends on the situation. So think of them as complementary. Two parts of a whole that can be applied in different proportions, in different ways, to the different dimensions of your work. The balance of systematic and systemic elements will vary along a continuum. What you look for and prioritise in your research will influence where you sit along that continuum. When dealing with complex problems, explore your potential for enhancing systemic elements. The Prevention Centre has downloadable tools to help. Visit preventioncentre.org.au/systems for more.